Yeah, it happened yesterday afternoon inside this apartment complex behind me. I'll step out of the way and let you see the investigation that's playing out still as we speak, more than 24 hours later. Neighbors heard several gunshots yesterday. One woman told me she and her kids laid on the floor for half an hour because they were so scared. Now, again, a day later, we don't know how or why this hostage situation started, but we do, tragically, know a lot more about how it ended.
Broke my heart. I'm just so upset by it.
A street is on lockdown and a neighborhood is shaken near Salem. Those living on or near Geneva Place Southeast just learned three people died here Monday afternoon, including a child.
You know, it's bad enough when adults are involved, but when children are involved too, it just hits in a whole different spot.
Marion County deputies got the call around 12:30 Monday. A hostage situation at this complex.
26 to dispatch. Can you find me a negotiator, please?
This is audio from dispatch recordings.
Just, you know, the plan right now is going to be for the negotiator to make initial contact when we have one.
Emergency vehicles piled up.
I heard one small siren and I looked outside the window and there was just a bunch of cops.
Nicole Purdy lives across the street. She pulled out her camera and shot this video. Meanwhile, Sean Robinson, who lives in that complex, came home to find his street closed.
I see this cop running across the street, just running for his life. Like he had just seen something absolutely horrifying.
Minutes later, Katie O'Kelly was in her bedroom with her grandson.
We both heard the shots. Three shots. Boom, boom, boom.
Oregon State Police, who are now leading the investigation, say deputies heard those shots from inside the apartment and forced their way in. As that happened, one deputy, they say, fired his weapon. Right now, it's not clear how many times or if the bullets hit anyone. Inside the apartment, OSP says deputies found four people shot. Three did not survive. A 24-year-old woman, Diari Bustos Bustos, was killed, as was an 11-year-old boy, who OSP is declining to name. Also found dead, Jose Jesus Lopez Tinoco. He was 34, and OSP is calling him the suspect. They say he apparently took his own life. OSP says two more people were inside that apartment, a 43-year-old woman who was shot but survived, and a 13-year-old boy who is unharmed.
It's heartbreaking. It really is. My heart goes out to all of those family members that are involved. I just want to cry when I think about it.
Again, you can see the investigators on scene here. The medical examiner just pulled up a little while ago. Right now, there's a lot we don't know, again, including the relationships of those who were in that apartment or what the source of the conflict was. Records show Lopez Tinoco, the one named the suspect, lives in Woodburn, a.k.a. not here. He also doesn't have any violent charges on his record, and so far we haven't been able to track down any family. Now, that Marion County deputy who fired an unknown number of shots at this point, we're told, has been placed on paid leave, which is standard in situations like these. And we're also told that Oregon State Police will only be releasing more information with the approval of the district attorney.